medications that ease the pain in autoimmune rheumatic diseases, NSAIDs, nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. The drug treatment of an autoimmune arthritis includes, number one, medications that control the disease and prevent its progression. We call them DMARDs, disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs. And number two, accessory, mostly temporary medications that ease the pain until the DMARDs control the disease. We call them painkiller medications. This video is about those painkiller medications. Just a reminder, now this is our model that we described in the lecture titled Types of Medications Used to Treat Autoimmune Rheumatic Diseases. Those are the officer cells, soldier cells, a happy hand that is not yet affected by arthritis. You have the disease button, it gets switched on, officer cells are activated, they produce the go signals, they tell the soldier cells attack with antibodies, they attack the joint with antibodies, so the joint produces the prostaglandin molecules or the ouch molecules that are responsible for the inflammation, which has symptoms and signs of pain, swelling, stiffness, inability, as you see in this knee joint. So, when a joint is attacked and inflamed in any autoimmune arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, ankylosing spondylitis, psoriatic arthritis, other so many types of arthritis, it is mainly one and the same type of inflammation molecules that causes the symptoms and signs. It is prostaglandins. Just to let you know, there are different types of inflammation molecules that are released by the different organs in the body that get inflamed. All those organs, they release inflammation molecules if they are attacked. But you see the joint here? Prostaglandins is the type that concerns us here in arthritis. So the best medications that will work on your symptoms of inflammation are those that can inhibit those prostaglandins. Prostaglandins, when they're active, they cause pain, swelling, stiffness, and inability. So medications that inhibit those prostaglandins will likely decrease the pain, the swelling, the stiffness, and the inability. Those medications come from one of two families, NSAIDs and cortisone. NSAIDs stands for nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, and this is the family that we mostly use. And cortisone, this is a type of steroids, but not the same steroids that some athletes are using. It's a different type, and there's a separate video in this series about cortisone and its use in the management of patients with autoimmune rheumatic diseases. Examples of NSAIDs in use: Brufen, Naproxen, Feldene, Voltaren, Celebrex, Arcoxia, Roxonin, and Indomethacin. Some of the famous ones. There are also other medication families that do not inhibit prostaglandins, but that can also ease the pain in the joints. Using those medications will likely decrease the pain, maybe some of the inability, but they will not affect the swelling and the stiffness really that much. Those medications belong to three other families. Simple painkiller medications like panadol, commonly used, we use it also. Painkiller narcotic medications like codeine and tramadol, less commonly used. Neuropathic pain medications, the most famous is the commercial name Lyrica. It's very famous. This is also used sometimes. So we know now that when it comes to painkilling, the four most important families of medications in practice of medicine are painkiller anti-inflammation medications, NSAIDs and cortisone, simple painkiller medications like panadol, painkiller narcotic medications like codeine, and neuropathic pain medications like Lyrica. NSAIDs are the agents of choice for the symptoms of an autoimmune arthritis unless there's a medical reason that prevents us from prescribing them. We call it a contraindication.